Hey guys, frame detailing or panelization. If you've ever had to create a set of drawings for somebody else to build the frames, you'll realize how long it takes. For instance, you've got to dimension them, especially if you're dealing with raked walls or sloping walls. And I'm going to show you how to do it quickly, accurately, and efficiently. Let's take a look. Okay, so what we have here is a dimensioned up set of external walls on a home. And I'm actually going to do this again for you in front of you. So you can actually see how we do it. You can see I've got a floor plan there, which I've imported to DWG, but I'm also going to create a set of working drawings that you can print out very, very quickly. And we can go through all of our walls individually and take a look at what it is that we're going to be doing. And I'm going to do this all in front of you, quick smart. So let's have a look. I'll go back to that file. I'm going to copy this out of here, so Control C. And I'm going to go to my new file, which is a blank file. You notice it has nothing in it. And I'm going to go File, I'll Edit, Paste in Place. And all I've basically done is imported my floor plan. Now I want to get this into 2D. So I've got a 2D mode here in PlusDesignBuild. And I now have my set of plans. I also want to draw it at 0, 0. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to quickly create a level. I'm going to call it Walls. And I'm going to make it at 0, and I'm going to make the walls say 2500 high. Okay, and I'm going to go save and update and make it active. Right. So now what I need to do, I can actually close this down there, and I'm going to go and choose my my wall. So now I've got the plan into it. I'm going to add, I've added my heights. I'm going to create frame walls. So what I do is I'm just going to go up to my wall tool, click on walls. And what I can do here is I can now create framed walls. So obviously I want to choose a construction type that has framed walls in there. And in this case, this plan is actually masonry veneer. So I'm going to choose that. Now inside my masonry veneer wall, I have framing and I'm going to have things like, will it have double studs in there? What's the stud spacing? What type of timber is it made out of? How many top plates will it have, bottom plates? And everything there, you can choose these yourself and you can update them later. So if you don't get too caught up in this and you actually start to chase them around, change these around later, you can go through and change these at any time and it will reconfigure the whole setup for you. One thing I do pay attention is my buffer for my windows. So for instance, I'm going to have a buffer at the top for shims or packing and buffers on the sides. Okay. So now I've done that, all I'm going to do is I'm simply going to go to my wall and I'm going to start to trace around it. Now you can see that the designer or architect of this drawing hasn't actually drawn my cavity in. Now, I did do a quick measurement on it before, and it was a standard 150 cavity. So what I've done is I've actually gone to the outside of my bricks, but I could have gone from the inside of my frame as well, and I'm just going to trace around my wall. I'm just going to do the external walls at the moment. Now, these are load-bearing walls, and in the wall tool, you'll notice that you have the ability to change whether they're carrying roof load or whatever it is. Okay. So what I've done is I've actually just drawn these walls up. And if I looked at it in the third dimension, you can see that I just have some brick veneer walls with some framing in there. Right. Okay, now we're going to assume that we have a gable wall here and a gable wall here. So what I'm going to do is use a keyboard shortcut for my walls, or I could have clicked up here, and I'm just going to basically say that these are gable, these two walls are gables. I say 25 degrees and go submit. Okay. And if I turn it back into the 3D, you'll notice that I have my walls there and gables. Okay, and now what I want to do is I want to start adding in my windows. So if I just go up to here and I go right click on my wall, I can go to windows and doors. I'm going to add windows first. Right. So inside of my window tool, I have the capacity to choose a window type, but more importantly, I can go through and I can choose the timber types, whether it's going to be LVL or I'm going to have single headers or double headers, and what size that header is going to be. Now at this stage I don't have any trusses drawn, so I'm just going to leave them all at the same size and I can edit them later if I choose. Right, so what I'm going to do is basically just go through and click where my windows are, and you'll notice that what's happening there is it's actually adding in headers, and we'll show you this in three dimensions in a second and break it down into frames like the drawing that I showed you earlier. And we might want to change our window height or window type. At any stage, we can do that. We can just go in here and say, let's say this window is going to be 600 high. Right here and here. Okay, and if I go around to this next wall here, I'm going to go shift. and we might just change this window height to say 1800 or let's say 1600 just for the point of the exercise and go submit. Right, now I'll go and put these two front windows in. In a second, I'm going to show you a full frame layout detail, all according to the sizes that I've added in as I went. I've got one more over here, and this is a door, so I'm going to go add door. Add door. Alright, door, and I'm going to go say an external door, and maybe a swinging door. I'll quickly put that in here. I can type in the width of the door. You can see that it automatically snapped to the plan at 820, but I can type in 820 and enter, and I can add my door. Same with the garage door. Here you can see very easily where that garage door is. And we've added our garage door. You can see we've got a couple more windows over here. So I'm just going to go in. I'm going to select more windows, right click, add windows. Now, in a second, I'm going to show you, as I said, all the headers, top plates and everything like that. And we're going to break this down. Sliding windows, we might just change these to a different size. We'll make these 1800, say. So I'm just clicking on the plan, but I could type in the measurement if I chose. Right. Okay, so I've got my windows in there, but we want to have a look at this, and we only want to see the framing because our main task today is to look at framing. So we have this scene tool, and if I click on the drop down here, I can just choose framing and go submit. Right, you'll notice that now when I actually look at that, it's actually broken it down and added the windows according to what it is that I required. I can also go through and right click and still add windows and doors in this view. So let's add a window, say here. Right, whatever it shows in the plan is where you're going to put this. Okay. Another thing is that this wall is so long. Now that would be unusual. Usually we build walls in manageable sizes and also according to the size of lumber that we can actually get. So if I just go back and said, right, I'm going to just use a grid here so that I can see where I should probably break up my walls. Oops. Grid, sorry, wrong one. Grid. Choose the length that is optimal for my timber sizes. Go in here, let's quickly just draw it over here. That way I'll be able to see where my walls should be broken down. All right. If I go back to my 2D mode there, I can see, okay, well here's at 4.8, I can move this grid around to suit myself and so on. So what I can do is I can actually go through and split the wall up to the maximum sizes of my grids, and you would notice that I would try and do that on a wall. So if I right click on my wall and go to walls, wall operations and split wall, I can simply go through and say, okay, well that looks like I'd split it there, I'm going to split it here, and notice I'm splitting on the right hand side of the wall. I'm doing it consistently because when I want to add all of my junctions in there, it's going to make it easier for me to do. Enter. Okay, let's get back and have a look at our frame drawing or our structural drawing, and you'll notice that my walls are split but they don't have junctions in them yet. So if I actually select these set of walls here, say those ones there, and I actually went right click, walls, advanced framing options, I can go through and I can choose my corner configuration, and in this case I want to use a three stud corner and I want to finish with a flat. However, you might want to do California corner, four stud corner or whatever, but just typically we would use three stud corner. At the same stage I can override my top plate, so at the moment my top plates are 90 by 45, but I can change them to 90 by 35 and use two ribbon plates instead. And I might want to add a pressure treated ground floor frame. Now, I'm doing this in metric, but this can also be done in imperial. So if I go and go submit, what it's going to do is going to go through and change the length of all my studs because I've used a different stud thickness, top plate thickness, but it's also gone through and it's added in all of the junctions accordingly. If I go back to all here, we'll see what happens. If I go into a translucent view, you'll notice that I have all of my studs in there as such. Now the same thing would happen with internal walls. If we wanted to go back to internal walls, we would just choose internal walls and we would trace over these. Now I haven't gone through and broken all these walls down into 4.8 because it's repetitive, but I think you can see. Now Now we need to get to the point where we can actually get some documentation on site. So what I'm going to do, you notice it's just an untitled, unsaved model. I'm just going to quickly go and go save, and I call it Panelization Drawing Demo. Okay, and go save. Right, so now I've saved it. You'll notice that up here we have this framing panelization tool. If I click it, it gives me the option to create a layout file, which is basically where my 2D documentation is done. Right, back to here. And if I can choose the paper size that I wanted to set them out on, I can choose the orientation of this landscape. I can display my units. So for instance, I'm drawing in millimeters. If I wanted millimeters to be drawn on my plans, I'd tick that. I can dimension it inside a SketchUp as well, so I can double check it. And I can override my existing scenes up here. I'm not going to do that. And do I want to show my units? Go submit. Okay, you'll notice at the top here, it's starting to create these scenes. And these scenes are basically breaking this model down and dimensioning the model so that we can actually utilize them to look at, to start, to ensure that I haven't made a mistake when I'm tracing or so on, but also so we can actually use these drawings to create panel drawings or shop drawings that we can create. So I'm just going to open up this file here, and that's going to open up another file down here. Okay, close. Right, and what it's actually done, it's gone through and labeled all of my walls. So you'll notice that at the top here, we have all of our wall numbers, and they're all dimensioned just for a layout style. But if I actually go to my next file, or I go down and start to look through these files, you'll notice that it's actually broken these down into walls. It's even dimensioned the top plate for me and set out my studs on the rake because this takes so much time on site. Now, it is going to automatically dimension, and you can move dimensions around as you see fit, wherever you want them to go, and if there's something that's repetitive, you can remove those dimensions. But very, very quickly, did I have a set of plans that I can actually go through and start to name and add it into a job? Now, what about the cut lengths? Well, the cut lengths are dimensioned there as well, but if I actually went back to that file, and we'll just go back to the SketchUp file, a second. There, and I have started to have a look through this, you'll notice that it's also dimensioned in 3D inside of SketchUp. Right, and if I went back to all of my structure, you'll notice that if I turn my dimensions on and off, that I can actually look at all of my walls as we would actually build them on site, and therefore I can give this to a subcontractor very, very quickly. However, if I actually wanted to get a cut list in, say, a spreadsheet form, I would go and click my takeoff, and inside of my takeoff, I would actually go in and I would change it to an advanced framing, because at the moment, it's just giving me the total lineal meters of everything that's required or everything I selected inside of those walls. However, I actually want to have an advanced framing option. So you'll notice that I have the option here to click Advanced Framing and go Generate and Update a Report. Now when I go to Advanced Framing and go to Edit See More, you'll notice that it's actually labeled the type of the product, so common stud, junction stud, top plates, ribbon plates, and everything like that. It'll also highlight if I've got anything over the maximum size chosen. You can see here, wall number 2 has an 8.3 meter length. So if I click on that, it highlighted that I have an 8.3 meter length here, which makes it really easy to be able to make edits. I can then go back to this wall, and I can split my wall very, very quickly. So let's have a quick look here, split wall, you go enter. Now I split my wall. If I go back and refresh my takeoff, framing, advanced framing, edit, see more. I no longer will have that red dimension in there, which makes it really easy. You can see I've got a couple more there, but I think you get the idea. Now, I can also export this to a spreadsheet. So if I went export takeoff, and I went and said, let's export cut and order list, which would basically be the length we're going to cut it, but the length we're also going to purchase that piece of timber in. And I'll quickly just call this one here demo and go save. Here it is here. Bring that over to here, and now you'll notice that it's got the level that I drew it on. So for instance, if it was a multi-story building, it would have level 1, level 2, level 3. It's given me my wall number, it's given me everything and the name of the member. Now in some cases we call things different in different countries or even geolocations, but basically I've got my wall number, the size, the name of the product, the length to cut it, and the length to order it from. And that's a huge time saver. So just to do what I've done there is probably 4 or 5 hours work, probably a whole heap more for a professional that does it every day. So as I said, you can go through and you can edit the names of everything inside of here. So if I wanted to go through my wall tags and I wanted to change the name of common stud to standard stud or something like that, I can go through and change all of those names very, very quickly. Okay, so guys, what we're doing here is we've automated the process so that we can save a whole heap of time on site. We can become more accurate, we can become more efficient, we can become more cost effective, so we know the cost of a project. But more importantly, we can communicate with the guys on site or the guys in the factory to ensure that they're building exactly what has been drawn and what has been designed. And that's going to save us all a heap of time. So guys, if you've got any comments, leave them below. If you like the video, push like. If you dislike the video, push dislike and tell us why, because we're here to improve. We're here to improve the industry. We're here to improve efficiency for builders all over the world. Cheers, guys.